If you take this segment right here, the question is, find x prime, y prime. They only want you to move it one time. Here, you could take the segment right here, and you can move it this way one time. That's what they're looking for. But it required two moves to get it to here. Or you could take the segment and you can move it down. Now it's in position, and then slide it to the right. So there's two possible answers here. I'm just going to move it to the right, and that's what they want. Or at least that's what I'm going to give them. If I don't see that, then I'm going to do it the other way. All right, so here we go. This is how you do it. If you move it to the right, you're changing the x value. So watch. This point right here is located at 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's negative 4. And then up 1, 2, 3. Point B is located at negative 2, up 1. Is everybody clear on where we are? If you can't tell where the point is, you got some serious learning to do. So what we're going to do now is take point B and slide it over to here, right above this one. I overshot it last time. So it's got to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It looks like I got to go over 5. So the x is going to change by 5. Only the x. And that's going to give me my answer. So when you change it by 5, the new point, A prime, should be 1 and 3. B should be 3 and 1. Let's check it. Over 1, up 3. A prime. And then over 3, up 1. B prime. And if you draw that, you have the answer. And that's all they want is the first move, A, X prime, Y prime. I guess I should change that to A prime, B prime. Is everybody clear on what I'm saying? All right. That was on that EOC practice sheet that Mr. Lee did, or similar to it. This one right here, to find the midpoint, you add up the x's. So that's going to be 6 divided by 2. And then you add up the y's, and that's going to be 18 divided by 2. So the midpoint, and don't miss this one, is 3, 9. You could graph it and see if it's in the middle. It should be. Any questions on how to do midpoint? Real simple. That's, look, add up what's 7 plus negative 1 and what's 6 divided by 2 and what's 12 plus the 6 and 18 cut in half is how much? 9. Is everybody clear on that? Midpoint. It's halfway. All right, perpendicular. Which one of these is my slope? Does anybody know which one is my slope? Is it the 1? Is it the x? What is it? It's the 1/3. But to get perpendicular, you got to do two things. What's the first thing I do? FO. You got to flip it, and you got to write the opposite. This is the answer. Any questions on how to do perpendicular? The book says negative reciprocal. Same thing. All right, put away your bell work. This one is also a review. Draw the diagram and find the area of the sector. Draw the diagram. Thank you. Draw the diagram and find the area of the sector. Remember, the whole circle is pi radius squared. But we don't want the whole thing. We only want a fraction of the whole thing. A fraction. So put down pi radius squared, that's the whole circle. So what fraction would you use? It's easy. We've had this before. What fraction would you use? Okay, you two girls have two tardies. One more will be at after school detention for an hour.
Or before school.
Or before school. Well, pi radius squared is the whole circle, but we don't want the whole thing. So you start off with the whole circle, and then you multiply by some fraction. Does anybody know what fraction I use? 30 over what? Is everybody clear on that? 30 over 360. Casey, you got to pay attention now. So this is going to be 30 times 3.14 times the radius squared divided by 360. And when you do it, you should get 16.7. Any questions on how to do this problem? It's called area of the sector. It's like a slice of pizza. You're not going to eat the whole thing. You're only going to eat one slice of it. All right. Draw this diagram and try this one. See if you're smart enough to figure out what X is.
Draw the diagram and try to figure out what X is. Two people in here are going to lose some of their 10 points because you're not doing what I'm asking you to do. I don't want to hear any crying. No, it's not huge. All right, tell me how to do it, Troy.
Well, that line equals 180 degrees.
Correct. All right, the line is 180. That's correct. It's half a circle. So the line is worth 180 degrees. That's correct. But this triangle is worth 180. So if this is 30 and this is 70, that's a total of 100. So that makes this one 80. And when you subtract 80 from 180, you get 100 degrees. Now, that's not the only way to do it, but that's the way most kids do it. How many of you got 100 on that exterior angle? All right, very good. Any questions on this one? It's not a hard problem. Memorize it. That's the way you do it. All right, now here are some notes for the new section. Copy down what you see on the screen. We're dealing with isosceles triangles. There are three types of triangles. You have something called a scalene, which sounds like a horrible name, but scalene means no sides are equal. Isosceles means two of them are equal. And then the equilateral means all three are equal. If it's an equilateral, they're all 60s. If it's an isosceles, it could vary. Plus, you have to know the terminology of the parts of a triangle. If you look at the back of a dollar bill, you see a pyramid. And up at the top, you see an eye, the eye of the pyramid. That's your vertex angle.
that upper angle is called the vertex. The two sides that are equal are called the legs, like your legs. Those are called the legs. The one on the bottom is called the base.
Now, geometry deals a lot with triangles, probably more than anything else. Now, draw this diagram and see if you can answer these two questions before I tell you. All right, so here we go. Does anybody know why this side right here, AB, is equal to this other side here? Can anybody tell me why? All right, you got to write down these rules. It's probably a theorem, but we're going to call it a rule. If base angles equal, base angles are congruent, then sides opposite are congruent. Copy this down. If base angles of a triangle are congruent, then the sides opposite the triangles are congruent. These are the properties of an isosceles triangle. Now, write the converse of what I just said. Switch them. It's good practice. It is true. Write the converse. If opposite sides are equal, then what? If opposite sides are equal, then what? Then the base angles are equal. All right, both of those rules apply. So, here you have the base angles are equal, therefore these sides are equal. I'm going to say it again. Base angles are equal, therefore these sides are equal. What is the measure of angle A? Well, angle A, no, it says why is angle A congruent to this one? Let me make sure that's the one. No. It's DEA. It's this angle here. So why is it equal to this angle? So put a question mark right there. Can anybody tell me why A and this angle are equal? They can't say angle E, because if you said angle E, it could be that one, or the whole angle, the straight angle. Does anybody know why those two little angles are equal? Yes.
Because the legs are equal.
Very good. Let me point that out with the laser. Since this leg is equal to that leg, then the angles have to be equal. Very good. That's the converse. All right, try to work this one. Let's see if you can figure this one out. Draw the diagram and try and figure out what X is. Draw the diagram and try and figure out what X is.
They give you the two legs are equal. Or you draw the diagram. If the legs are equal, then the base angles are equal. It's not hard stuff. You just have to try to do it. All right, who can tell me? How do I work it? Go ahead, Courtney.
Is X 40?
This is, I think it is 40. This is 50, so what is this one? So 50 and 50 is how much? 100. So this upper angle, the whole thing, the whole vertex angle is how much? It's got to be 80, and then half of 80 is 40. Good. All right, that's pretty much it. Let's just try this last one right here before we get started. See if you can figure out what X and Y is. Draw the diagram. This is similar to the one we did earlier, but it's kind of like the converse of it. Here they give you the exterior angle. And they give you an isosceles triangle. So see if you're smart enough to figure this out. Now tomorrow, I'm picking up work from last week. If you have four demerits and you don't turn in your work tomorrow, you're going to end up with probably a six demerit form. You do not want to be on probation coming back to school next year. If you don't turn in that six demerit form the next day, I'm not giving you any extra time. You're going to get an hour detention. Because I'm not playing games. When I fill out that 12 demerit form, it's going to stay. I don't want any excuses. Yes. You got it? All right. So this is 100. Right here. How much is this?
80.
It's 80. And since the sides are equal, how much is that? 80. So how much is this upper angle? That's it.
Why is that 80?
It's an isosceles triangle.
Is the line at the bottom?
A line is worth 180. I'm not sure which your question is, but. All right, here's your assignment right here. What's your question, Spencer? Nope. Anything that I gave you before is fair game. I don't want to tell you specifically.